week, when focusing on the question of who as an antithesis to the question of how or why, I tied in two different accounts. The first was the account of a man born blind, and when the disciples asked Jesus, who sinned that this man was born blind, his parents or him? And the other quote I said was from today's gospel, when the disciples couldn't expel a demon from someone, but Christ could. And they asked him, why do we cast out this demon? Just a few moments ago, we heard our Lord's answer to that question, why couldn't we cast out this demon? Christ first says they don't have enough faith, but goes on to inform them, quote, this kind can only be cast out through prayer and fasting. I have a feeling that hearing that they didn't have faith and that they weren't fasting and praying would be quite a blow to their egos. Imagine being able to cast out demons, and then one shows up that won't leave, but with just as much effort as anyone else, Christ casts it out. That would put lots of thoughts and doubts into anyone's mind. The disciples were certainly confused, so they asked, how come we weren't able to cast out this demon? I wonder if Christ's answer to them satisfied what they really wanted to know. I know for me, in our Western way of thinking, where 1 + 1 + 1 = 3, rather than capital O-U-O-N-E, I would want to know just how much fasting do I need to do? Exactly how should I pray to be able to cast out demons like this one? I'm quite certain we would be right where the disciples were at spiritually. I have a feeling if we're being honest with ourselves, our inner monologue would sound something like this. Lord, I don't know what happened here. Just tell me what to do so it won't happen again. Make this easy for me to control these situations. And this is a textbook example of the Western mindset I've mentioned. Remember, the Western thought is, let's take it apart to see how it works. But the Eastern Orthodox mindset is, let's step back and observe how it acts. It's that Eastern mindset that we must apply here, because we're not dealing with a what about which we can ask questions like how or why. Remember, we're interacting with a who. The who with whom we're interacting is an unknowable God, the unknowable, all-powerful creator of all, who wants to be in a relationship with us, his creation. So we shouldn't try and answer questions of how or why, but instead we should step back and observe how the relationship acts. If we step back and observe this scene, we see the disciples going to the Lord. We see them in their frustration and confusion turning to him with faith that he will take care of the problem. An important observation to make, because it should cause us to reflect on what the situation would look like if they could do everything without the help of God. This concept is quite similar to the parent-child relationship. When the child is very young, he or she is dependent on their caregiver for everything. And slowly, they need the caregiver less and less until they don't need the caregiver at all. It's a proud moment for the child to leave the parents and go off on their own, but it's a sad moment for the parent, who will get less and less interaction with their child. My point is, there's more to Christ's answer than meets the eye. He says that prayer and fasting are necessary to cast out this kind of demon. But what does prayer and fasting require? It requires communion with our Lord. It requires us to put him first and our ego aside. Our ego that makes us believe that we can do things without him. When we've done something well a multitude of times, we may start eliminating God from that task. This might be what the disciples did. They got comfortable with their own abilities and called on Jesus less than they should have. And so only in their moment of failure and confusion did they go to him and ask for help. This concept is unfortunately all too familiar to us. When we're scared of impending danger, when we're nervous about up in responsibilities, or when we're unsure about intense situations, we offer simple prayers like, God, help me. Or complex prayers on our knees before icons and with lit candles. Then, maybe not every time, when we're delivered from the outcome of our situation, we move on from it, leaving our prayer of thanksgiving unsaid. Which is half bad, I suppose, because at least for half of that situation, we weren't communicating with our Lord. We were trying to be close to Him. But that begs the question, do we expect our Lord to come to us? Or should we expect to go to Him? With only anecdotal evidence, I suggest that we want God to come to us when we summon Him in times of peril, and that we're okay if He wanted to make Himself known to us at other times with something like a grand miracle. That's not how relationships work. The kids who go off to college and don't call, don't write, or even plan on visiting over break because they were invited elsewhere, quickly pick up the phone and then receive a tuition bill with an eye-popping amount of money due. Loving parents, of course, answer the phone and are happy to help. But there's some disappointment, too, that there hasn't been return phone calls, thank you cards, or texts for the treats that were sent. With this in mind, imagine if the disciples had been able to cast out every demon and cure every sickness without ever turning to God. If they were able to do that, to do everything on their own, they might return to Christ less and less. This is not what God wants for us. God wants us to be in a consistent relationship with Him. So we must pray and fast so that we can be in a relationship with Him. And I know I said that trigger word, we must fast. People can get hung up on fasting because they believe it's all about the food and they're too prideful to give up their pleasure. Fasting is so much more than giving up food. It's making choices that communicate a desire to draw nearer to our Lord. If you are feeling like there are demons that you can't expel from your life, or if you simply want to draw into a better relationship with our Lord, make an appointment with a priest and discuss what prayer and fasting looks like for you right now, where you're at in life. Because as St. Theodore on the Recluse wrote, where there is no prayer and fasting, there are the demons. In the name of the Father, and of the Son,